What I do requires a certain mindset. I do assignments. Designated targets. Some jobs need to look like accidents. Others must cast suspicion on someone else. A select few need to send a clear message. Pulling a trigger is easy. The best jobs are the ones nobody ever knows you are there. Passing through.
Thank you.
Of course, people might remember them.
Well, then that kind of defeats your purpose, doesn't it? Because I don't go anywhere without them, nowhere.
Try to get them suits to fit. They look like cartoons.
Everything went okay?
You got done.
You know, I'm better than you, you know. That's why they give you those jobs. It could get a little hairy, because if they were to get hairy, then you would take care of it, and that's all they care about. Services rendered, no loose ends. Fait accompli. You're a goddamn machine. You see things, you view people differently than I do, differently than anybody does. But you got a problem, Arthur. You need companionship.
I have you, Harry.
Oh, then you're in deeper shit than I thought.
So how's Steven?
Did I tell you that I got him a job at a private security firm? We kicked him out last month. He beat some guy half to death. Goddamn disappointment. Always has been, always will be.
Call him.
Me? Call him? Or what?
He probably needs to hear from you.
Let's go. I got your money.
You ever gonna tell me your name?
Arthur.
Nice try. You're no Arthur. No, more like David. Or Brad. Yeah. I see you, Brad.
Your 2 Saturdays at the shelter. 8 days and 3 Saturdays.
That's right.
Done.
How do I get one of those?
Let me talk to
you. You can't. Unless you're a world champion.
Just tell him to come on and fix it, honey. All right, let's go. I've just been out negotiated by a 16-year-old. Let's take a walk. Months ago, we were commissioned to undertake the largest contract we've ever attempted. Target was far more high profile than we're normally comfortable with. The job was just too rich to pass up.
Target was South Africa?
The target fled to South Africa. That's where we made our move, Cape Town. It took 6 months to set up. I assigned a team of 5 operatives to work in concert on the mission. All 5 were killed. Someone knew everything. You probably knew some of the men on that team.
This one, Sebastian.
You know how this company works, Mr. Bishop. Only 2 partners know the details of any given job. 2 people know the details here. Me and Harry McKenna. Harry sold us out. We pulled his financials. Take a look at recent offshore deposits. There's one there made 2 weeks ago for $20 million. He's gotten old. He's gotten weak. He's loaded with debts. They made him vulnerable. And for the past 13 years, I have been fiercely loyal to him. There's no one I respected more. But Harry McKenna has poisoned the well. He needs to be removed. Immediately.
Let me talk to him.
Look, I appreciate your connection with Harry. But there's no turning back here. He has crossed his Rubicon. Every day that he's alive puts this company in danger. Now, we would all prefer that you handle this. Given your relationship, you're in the best position to get this done quickly and discreetly. And to be honest with you, I hate the idea of Harry suffering unnecessarily. We don't want to go to an outside source, but we will if we have to. Excuse me a second. Jess, negotiations are closed. I'm sorry. I'm in a meeting. Okay, hang on. 48 hours. Or we'll proceed without you. Quit while you're ahead.
Yeah, I mean, Roosevelt, to be truthful, is my hero. I mean, the way he dealt with it. Damn chair. You guys want to put your trousers up there? please. Put your trousers on. You know, the suits don't really fit you guys very well.
Out of the building, Harry.
Arthur?
They're coming for you tonight.
Who was coming?
Dean. Take whatever you can use against them and get out.
Oh, Jesus.
Do you have a pair of scissors?
Yeah.
Go to the elevator lobby.
On my way.
Looks like we've got a power outage on the AT4.
We have 15 seconds to get to the service elevator before the emergency power comes on.
There's a kid there.
Punch in the building number.
I thought we cut the power off.
Service elevators have to work on a separate power source.
I'm in.
That's the basement floor. The elevator will take 18 seconds to get there. The level is empty and unused. Take the ramp. It connects to the building next door. It leads to an underground parking lot. Security cameras haven't been fitted in this building yet, so they'll be blind. Okay, you should be entering the parking lot now.
My van's here. Circumvent my own security. Nobody sees me leave. So what's this? Cape Town, right? Yeah. Right. So what's the story here? Carjacking? Police will find my van somewhere in some shithole section of the city. Stripped and up on blocks?
Something like that.
Slight editorial revision. You don't mind, do you? I met Victoria Carl. Get off a couple of shots, there's a struggle, they get my gun, c'est la vie. At least I don't go down looking like a pussy. I've had that for 33 years. Gifting. That's the first time I ever fired it. Just send somebody else. I would rather it was you, Arthur. I have to live with it.
fucking bishop. So it'd be a loss. More of a loss for you than me, buddy. Hey, would you give me a ride to my father's house? Your father talks about you a lot. Talked about spending time with you, maybe making up.
A bit of rest, would you?
Yeah, well, he was always bringing you up. He had regrets, Stephen.
Yeah, he could have picked up the phone anytime. As a kid. It's pretty impressive, huh? Every one of them served their country. I guess I could still enlist. You know, make them proud. Fucking with you. I don't know if you have a picture of them, but I thought maybe you.
Sticking around.
What? You didn't leave a will. Accounts are empty. Bank's gonna take the house. By the time a lawyer, city, and state get through with the rest, not gonna be a fucking thing left.
Where you headed?
Next place.
Need some money?
No, thanks. I got a guy coming to the house. He's gonna look at the car. I figure that'll probably get me through on to the next spot.
What about the guns?
I was thinking about going out and killing myself a couple carjackers tonight.
Just any old run-of-the-mill carjacker.
Yeah, well, you never know. I might get lucky, find the guys that killed my dad.
I'm gonna make you feel better.
Fuck if I know. We'll find out.
Sleep it off, Steve.
Hey, Bishop. What kind of person shoots someone in a wheelchair anyway? I think I got it. Mm-hmm. Supposed to meet a friend, and I might have gotten the address wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe. Well, maybe the address got me wrong.
Nice car, man. Nice car.
Thanks.
Can I have it?
What?
I'm relieving you of your automobile, motherfucker. Out of the car.
Seriously?
Seriously.
Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. Okay.
Gladjacker.
Did you shoot him with this?
Fuck.
Is this the gun you used?
No.
Seem like it, but tonight's your lucky night, Raymond. What do you ask? She fell down. We just come looking for you. Yeah.
Stupid to kill someone when you have a motive. Might as well paint a bullseye on your back.
I don't give a shit.
Chose you over me, you owe him. And now that he's gone, he's left me with fucking nothing. You owe me now.
Go home, Steve.
Still for sale. You know you want it. No other lifetime but this one. Want some advice? Follow what this tells you. It's trying to tell you something. It's telling you you're homesick for a place you've never been.
Tomorrow.
more shelter.
Yeah, I know what it is. Why are we here?
Look for a dog like this. Under a year, if possible.
I don't take any more for a cat person.
You know what a mechanic is outside its obvious definition?
Guy who fixes things, problems, has contracts. A hitman.
Do assignments. Designated targets.
I could do that. I've seen some shit.
No, you haven't.
You know shit about me, Bishop.
Stephen Jackson McKenna, born in Baltimore, Maryland. Your mother died when you was 12, a mixture of pain meds and vodka. You attended 3 different high schools, Grant, Deer Park, and Monroe. Lettered in 4 sports, got a scholarship from Miami that was rescinded upon a conviction of possession with intent to distribute. Had 4 misdemeanors for aggravated assault and unlawful threats against 2 different girlfriends. Broke your kneecap in a street fight. Didn't want to tell anyone, so you let it heal on its own. And when it rained, you woke with a limp. I'll show you the x-rays if you like. A friend here would like to adopt this little fella. Good boy. It requires a certain mindset. Revenge is an emotion that can get you killed, so no more stupid stunts like the other night. Walk it, feed it, make it your best friend. Tomorrow, 11, Fisher Square. To the coffee shop on Riverdale. Order a coffee, black. Sit at a table by the window and do the Sudoku puzzle in the paper. Play nice with the dog. For how long? 1 hour. Every day for the next 3 weeks. Take your training to the next level.
Stand out here. tell you, man. I'm a little skittish right now. Not sure if this is a good time for me to be doing anything. It's a lot of shit in the wind, you know?
I blew the list in the money. Now's not a good time.
Missing the list. All this by when?
As soon as possible.
All right. Take me a day to make it happen. Give me the money.
Autoerotic asphyxiation?
Yep.
Just know you should see when I'm close.
Touch this.
Job. Nothing more, nothing less. Makes you feel better. He was an illegal arms dealer. Sold weapons to anyone. Cop killers, gangbangers, terrorists. He didn't discriminate.
By looking at him, but he's a mechanic for another group. His only routine is coffee every morning from 9 to 10. Doesn't go any place twice except here. He's insulated and protected. No way in without him seeing us coming. Except he has two weaknesses. Chihuahuas.
Mind if I sit down, please?
And boys. Young boys.
Coffee black.
No doubt he's checked you out over the past 6 weeks and found no connection to you in this world. All he sees is a good-looking kid who's kind of lost.
You want to hold him?
Yeah. He likes that.
Come here, baby. Yeah.
If he's interested, the first thing he'll do is ask you.
So you live around here, Steve?
Your answer should be.
I'm bouncing around.
Which means you're broke and open to suggestions.
With my buddy.
Yeah. Then ask you if.
You, want to get a drink with him?
Your answer should be.
Yeah.
It's great, Andy.
Not a trazepam.
Ruthie. You want me to kill him, not rape him, right?
Two to three drops, he's woozy. Over six, so it stops in his brain dead in under 3 minutes. Do it in the bar. Make it clean.
Fancy places they always water down the roof. So I think that's why these are going down so fast.
They don't water down the wine, that's for sure.
It's really good.
Another one?
Yeah.
Jameson's right.
Jameson's double pleased.
Don't mess around with this guy. Do it in the bar.
I think I've had too many.
No, come on.
No, I think I'm gonna finish this one. I'm gonna finish this one, and I'm gonna. I really should go to bed, but it was fun.
Yeah, it's more of a hobby, really.
Pretty serious hobby.
Cheers. That's the sitting area, the fireplace.
Chillaxing room.
This is the place I'm most proud of, right here.
Who's this guy?
That is 14th century Buddha. That was a bitch to get into this country. It's nice to have friends. Good friends that make a difference. You got good friends? I mean, really good friends. You're shaking like a leaf.
Yeah.
to make it clean.
Outside individual to complete your assignment. That's a violation of our arrangement.
My arrangement was with Harry. You and I don't have one. Just the price. I would think someone trained by me would be valuable to you.
Harry McKenna's son. Does he know you killed his father? This job needs to be done immediately. The client's willing to pay a premium for it.
Just too quick.
Your behavior is making me and the others extremely uneasy. You're on a short leash with this one. The file is a priority.
I'll look it up.
Me and I touch his people.
Andrew Vaughn, 45 years old, calls himself the new Messiah.
So, Reverend Vaughn.
Just Vaughn. I'm not a reverend. I'm not endorsed by any of the world religions. I am above them. I am Vaughn.
He has made millions of dollars through his churches, his ministries, his television programs. Basically, he is running a cult. Adrenaline shot to the heart, 12 cc's, and he's dead under 3 minutes.
Adrenaline's unreliable. One enforced by cardiac arrest.
But when the EMTs arrive, first thing they do is jam you with a shot of epinephrine.
Which is toxic when combined with
adrenaline.
So on the off chance our adrenaline shot doesn't kill him,
the EMTs will. He left a Bible study group with a young devotee one night. They didn't find her body until 2 weeks later. The autopsy said she had an abortion and was telling her friends it was his. It cost him $22 million to hush it up.
Okay, let's get this over with. Bless you. Next.
But you come sit right here. You're new here, aren't you? How long have you been here?
2 weeks now.
How old are you?
18.
Sandwich, double chocolate cake. Bishop, I'm hungry. So the guy at the deli, he had Band-Aids on all of his fingers. You find a Band-Aid in your sandwich, it wasn't mine.
How do you think I feel?
Where's Frank?
Yeah, that's that. Well, we should be here any minute. Speak of the devil.
Give me something special today.
I feel like celebrating.
Spirit's work to do.
Spirit's a reward to do a favor. Mm.
The guy's a junkie.
He's giving him ketamine.
So?
Ketamine counteracts adrenaline. This won't work now.
Yes, it is.
In the king's name.
Hey,
good scope.
I would have done this right.
The truth.
Down his line.
Here with this junkie.
try and pick him up.
Some of the men on that team.
Does this live?
10-15 minutes.
as much time then.
What do you want?
I want to know what you're doing alive. Last time I saw you, you had a bullet in your head. What really happened in Cape Town? Where's the rest of your team?
They're dead.
Who paid you, wasn't Harry or Dean?
Dean paid me a very large amount of money to kill the others. Told me to fake my death, disappear. You know what else he told me? That Harry was getting suspicious about a blown operation. He was about to blow the whistle. It had to be taken care of.
Dean knew just the man for the job. Someone who could get to him.
It's not the fact that you killed them, is it? It's that they played you so easily. That's what bothers you. Am I right?
So good for your side.
Those were my two best teams. I guess I'll have to send more.
Save the fuel. Coming for you. Top shelf and put it in the boat. set. Get in the boat.
No. You ever kill someone you know?
Yes.
Did it feel any different?
Not in the moment. After. There's no peace.
So it's best not to let them know when you're coming.
Yes.
Because it doesn't really matter anyway, as long as they're dead and you're not, right?
I'd say that's a breach of professional ethics, Mr. Bishop. Harry's death was business, pure and simple.
Well, it's not going to be so simple now.
You got that right. Because now I'm going to put a price on your head that's so big, when you look in the mirror, your reflections are going to want to shoot you in the face.
You won't survive that long.
You're a fool. You think you can get to me before I get to you?
I already have.
Where's conference room, PD?
Floor upstairs, sir.
He's in the building. Get me the fuck out of here.
Had this anger inside. Now I feel like I have a place to put it. I think I would miss this if I had to stop now. I could always go into business for myself. There are a lot of people out there who would pay. And I think you were wrong. Vengeance is the mission.
table. Sorry for everything.